Hi everyone, it is me, Victoria, and Washington, my service dog, and my mom. You're trying to decide. Service dog. I have a disability that limits me from specific activities, and I need a service dog. Do I train it, or do I have it trained? Well, I am here to help. I am here to give you the pros and the cons of training your old service dog. So if you want to find out more, stick around.
He's no Romeo, but he's my loving one-man show.
Actually waiting on somebody to get out of a meeting, and I figured I might have enough time. I'm gonna go through pros and cons of training your own service dogs and why it can be good, but also just some of the things that might be more difficult. Why do you need a service dog? The biggest thing that I cannot stress enough is that the service dog has to be for you and for your specific disability and has to perform a specific task for you. Do you fit under the legal description of a disability under the Americans with Disabilities Act? I have something that I'm going to read out to y'all, and it's basically the definition of a person with a disability. An individual with a disability is defined by the ADA, Americans with Disabilities Act, as a person who has a physical or mental impairment that substantially limits one or more major life activities. A person who has a history or record of such an impairment, or a person who is perceived by others as having such an impairment. So basically, it is saying a disability is something is limiting you from your daily activities. Before I kind of get started into the pros and cons, I want to also mention, know ahead of time why you want the service dog. How is it going to help you specifically? What is it going to do for you specifically? Go ahead and write down a list. Write down the list of all the things you need the service dog to do for you. Make sure that it's specific to your disability. You need to have a plan. And that's the biggest thing that I would recommend out of this whole thing is have a plan, write it out. Just make sure you have a plan. I mean, One other thing I was going to say as well with Washington, my service dog, is that it does matter what I feed him. If it's a lot of grains and if it's kind of the starch and stuff that he does not need, he does tend to be more sporadic. He does tend to be more a little, just not controllable as much. It does matter what they eat to help you with the services that you are needing from your service dog. One last thing I was going to mention too is that it does matter how often you exercise your service dog. Washington, my service dog, I exercise daily. I try to get him out. I try to let him play with balls, kind of relieve that stress before a day, going out to work. There are days where I am unable to because of my disability, because of the rain. It could be anything, but let me tell you, when that happens, Washington can be a nightmare, and he's not with it. He's kind of wants to do something else, or he's not mentally there with me. He's not able to get it that I need him. When I call out his name or when I give him a task to do, it takes him a minute longer to kind of figure out, oh wait, she needs me. And so that's the one thing too, food, exercising, it does matter for a service dog. It just does. It does. And so definitely if you're thinking about getting a service dog, training it on your own, make sure you are committed to feeding him or her properly and definitely exercising your service dog just so that during the day it will go easier. Okay, so some pros that I have. The first pro, obviously, is that it saves a lot of money. It saves so much money me training my own service dog. Most of y'all already probably know other videos that are out there, but a service dog can cost between $10,000 and $25,000. I don't have that kind of money. I'm just gonna be putting it out there like there's no way I can do that. And the beauty about training your own service dog is that it is less expensive. Now, it can still be expensive. I'm not saying that it's not. You still have to maintain the food. You still have to maintain grooming. You still have to maintain their toys. There's definitely expense, but it is significantly cheaper. The beauty of this is that when you train your own service dog, you get to control how much money you want to spend into it. The second pro is that you get to pick your own breed. Now, this can be a pro and a con, but for me, it was definitely a pro. And it was a pro because you get to pick it and do your own research. I cannot stress enough how important it is. After you have decided that you want a service dog and that you want to train your service dog, I highly encourage you to do your own research and find out what type of breed I want. The breed matters big time. It matters because of their demeanor. It matters because of their temperament. It matters because of if they need to be small, if they need to be larger for mobility purposes. It's very important that you research ahead of time. The Lord truly blessed me with having a service dog that is just so good temperament and relaxed and laid back, and he just is eager to please. And his breed is eager to please. But there will be other service dogs that are a little more rambunctious and kind of likes to do more things. And, you know, you have to put a little more time and effort into it. But that's the biggest thing, if I could just encourage you. If you have decided to train your own service dog, definitely look up the breed that you want. I've heard of a few people going to shelters to pick out the dog that they want to use as a service dog. I am not saying this is a bad thing to do. I am not. But I do find that there are more risks when you do that, unless they're very young. I have seen tons of people that have service dogs, and they were rescues from shelters. So I'm just saying, go with caution if you decide to do that. And I also wanted to say that the ones that are in shelters that are mixed are called crossbreeding. You know, some people want to have their dog trained or train their dog professionally, get a certificate, that kind of thing, through the program, mind you. Certificate through the program, not a certificate to become a service dog. Just to kind of make the owner, the service dog handler, feel more comfortable. Like, okay, he's been tested. He can do these things out in public access, yada, yada, yada. So I wanted to make sure y'all understand that I'm not talking about certificate to become a service animal. I'm talking about certificate through the program that the service dog handler have decided to go through a program to get it trained. Some programs, if you do decide to have it professionally trained to get it certified, some don't do crossbreed. They do prefer full-breeded dogs. So again, Labradors, German Shepherds, Collies, that kind of thing, they do require that sometimes. So again, that is nice to have an option if you want to train your own and you want to rescue it and it's a mixed. You could do that. But again, research. That's the biggest thing I could say, is research before you do. Another beautiful thing about training your own service dog is that you can train it to do exactly what you need it to do. Some programs, they don't do necessarily exactly what you need it to do. Instead, they will do a mix, a genre of what most people like. And that is good, but sometimes you need that fine detail of, I need that dog specific to the task for the person with a disability that some programs may not have thought of before. So that's the beauty of training your own, is that it can be as specific as you need it. Sometimes programs don't cross-train. And what I mean by cross-train is that they don't do, like, some programs only do mobility. They don't do scent training. They don't do any other type of training. And with that, you can do different types of training. You know, if you needed a service dog to pick up the fact that you have seizures, you might want the dog to learn that. But also you need to teach the dog to brace if you feel like you're about to pass out. So there's just different things that to kind of be aware of if you need the service dog in there. So the next big pro about training your own service dog, and probably my biggest for me, is that the bond that you have with your service dog when you are training it is undeniable. The bond that I have with Washington, my service dog, is incredible. He is my best friend. I can rely on him. I can count on him to do his job. The bond, it's indescribable. It really is. And that is probably my favorite part about training my service dog. Isn't our bond just so wonderful? We have the best bond. And that meaning also too is that they're loyal. The breed that I got, being a German Shepherd, I know that for a fact that if I had sent him away, there's no way our bond would be what it is today. And so I'm grateful for the opportunity to get to do that and start from scratch almost, you know. And also, the last that I can think of so far, there's so many other pros, and I've tried to think of good ones, but the kind of the last one I think for me is, just because you train your own service dog doesn't mean you have to do it all on your own. And this is where the financial part kind of comes back into play. But some people still want the help to train their service dog. And some people want to know how to do obedience training. Like, I got this and this and this. Like, I got the, I know how to make him brace. Or I know how to get him to help me up and help me stand up. What I don't know is how to get him to stop whining in a meeting. Just something like that. Some people want help in specific areas of training their service dog, and advice and pointers of how to help their service dog become more obedient, really. And ways you can do that is YouTube, books, your local trainer. You have tons of options, and you're gonna struggle, and that's okay. But knowing that I had that option without it having to be $10,000 just to get him to sit on command, you know, I mean, you get what I'm saying? There's so many other pros about training your own service dog. Those are just the few that I could think of right at the moment. Now let's get into the cons. The first con that I think that pops right into my head is that it takes time. It takes a lot of patience. And the reason being is that don't expect it to be quick and easy. If you're thinking it's going to be quick and easy to train your own service dog, don't do it, because it is not quick and it is certainly not easy. Washington and I have definitely had some days where I wanted to give up and be like, you are ridiculous, I cannot do this again, and when are you gonna get it, kind of thing. And here's the thing, a lot of service dog owners make it look so effortless and easy. It's not. Washington and I worked on so many commands. Like, the biggest one I think for him was actually something so silly, is he wouldn't get in the car. He would not get in the car. I had to either help him up, I had to help him. He would just give you this pitiful look and just turn his head around and be like, do I have to? And he's just like, dude, you should know this. You should just get in the car. It's not even a task for me. It's just to get in the car. And an actual task that we had troubles with a lot is to hold items in his mouth. It's like he would want to just spit it out. And it's like, dude, no, just hold it for 2 seconds. Other handlers make it look so easy. You have to get creative. You have to think of other ways of training. It's not easy. I cannot say that enough. But you got to understand, it took a lot for us to get there. It took a lot of training. It's not easy. Another reason why it can be a little more difficult to train your own service dog is, depending on your disability, you may not be able to train your service dog to do specific abilities. Now, I do think some people kind of throw it out of the water like that's not an option. I disagree. I think there are different ways of training a service dog if someone uses a wheelchair and are unable to use their arms. There are definitely limitations, and there are definitely more extra steps one might have to take, whereas I didn't have to take, for someone who is limited with their disability to train their own service dog. So there, it can be more difficult, but definitely possible, in my opinion. You just have to be creative is really what you have to do. Another reason why it might be a little more difficult is because someone has a disability and they need the service dog right away because of their disability, and they do not have the time to train the service dog based on their disability. It just really bums me out when I see stuff like that, because the bond needs to be there. This next con is actually a big doozy in my book, because it can get really tough and difficult and just sad. There is always that chance that when you train your own service dog, that that dog is just not able to be a service dog. And that can be from temperament, it can be from focus, it can be from, it could be anything, but there is a chance when you try to train your own service dog that it's just not gonna happen. And that truly is heartbreaking, just because we want it to work out, and it takes a lot of time and effort, and to go through all that and then knowing it's just not gonna happen is truly heartbreaking. It truly is. I can't imagine what someone would go through knowing that they have tried, it wasn't the handler's fault, they did all the right things that they could, it's just that the dog was unable to provide the tasks, or the dog wasn't obedient enough, and the dog just wasn't able to do it. I know that that is always a risk, especially if you go to a shelter. This is where the shelter part comes in, that when it's a mixed breed, I believe a higher risk of that happening. But again, it doesn't have to be with just shelter dogs. It can be with a breed like a German Shepherd. It can be any breed that just is unable to do it, and that's okay. You know, they can stay as a house dog. They can stay as a family pet. The last con, I think, about training your own service dog that is actually pretty common is that people just lose interest. They feel like, yeah, I can train my own service dog. That's easy. I can do that in 2 months. And then they kind of go into 6 months and they're like, hey, this is not going anywhere. Never mind, you're not my service dog. You know what? My disability is not that bad to have a service dog. And that really paints a bad picture of those who really have tried and worked hard at training their own service dogs. And I guess the biggest thing that I have to say about that is that if you find out that your service dog is not trainable, or you lose interest, or you change your mind, you no longer want to have the service dog, please don't bring it out in public. I beg you, just don't bring it out to public, because it really does paint a bad picture for us who truly do need a service dog. And that is it. Washington and I want to thank you so much for watching. I hope those pros and cons were beneficial, and I hope maybe you learned something out from it. And I hope it kind of somewhat excites you of all the possibilities that are possible with training your own service dog. I really do hope it helps. For those who are just unsure if you even want a service dog, I urge you just do your own research. Find out why you need the service dog. Find out what makes a disability. And find out what training you would need the service dog to do and to go through to best serve you. And if you have any questions or comments, please leave them down below. Please make sure to like and subscribe and tune in for the next video. Bye!